Howdy, howdy, folks. Welcome to HT's EDC. Coming back at you on this Valentine's Day today. Just wanted to do another open tag by one of my good buddies, Georgia Adventure, Brother Randy. One of my favorite channels. Great guy. Happy Valentine's, Brother Randy and Miss Linda. But I wanted to take part in his open tag, Wharncliffe Wednesday. And I hope this is okay, Brother Randy. I'm going to do a modern for Wharncliffe Wednesday. I know, Brother Randy, you carry some Benchmades, what do you call it, the 795, the Walmart Ozark Trail you've been kind of reviewing. I know you have a few in your collection as well, so I don't believe you will get too offended if I show a modern on Wharncliffe Wednesday. But I did a short on this, on a short video showing this guy, and this is going to be the full review of this is going to be a heavily customized Spyderco Yojimbo 2. And give you a tour around this thing. And this is not what one's going to look like a stock model out of the store. I have added quite a bit of aftermarket stuff on here, and we'll go into that. But go ahead and get this thing open. This is what it looks like on the show side. Definitely a wild Wharncliffe blade. We will get into this blade here in a little bit. We'll just go ahead and take you for a tour. We have a aftermarket, a Lynch Northwest. I don't know if that, this camera won't do that justice, I'm sure, but kind of a, I don't know if you want to call that a carbonized exactly handle, but it's got some blues in there to match these scales. A really cool clip. Maybe there, help it out a little bit. Anyway, that is not the clip that came on this knife. These are not the scales that originally came on this knife. And this blade has been black washed with an acid wash. This was a black bladed at one time. That's not true. This was not black. It was just a satin, regular finish blade on here that we have black washed. Let me get a swig of. Yeah, maybe we'll wake up and make sense. This was an uncoated blade to start with, and now we have it, a nice black wash, acid washing on here. I think it looks really cool. The hardware, we've went with blue hardware to match these blue G10 scales. But yeah, we have customized this one quite a bit. There's some of that pocket clip coming in, pretty cool. But folks, I know this is a very polarizing Spyderco. This was designed as honestly a fighting knife, a self-defense knife, which I am not a knife fighter. I have not been trained. I just thought it was very unique. You're either going to love the Yojimbo or you're going to hate it. It's probably going to be no middle ground. Believe it or not, it is very ergonomic in hand. Again, it was designed for knife fighting and self-defense, so it is, and Spyderco always does a good job in ergonomics, but this one really melts into your hand, so it is comfortable as far as that. You're either going to like this blade shape or you're not. I get that. It is polarizing. Got a big deployment hole here. We have the compression lock Spyderco is known for. Have some jimping right up here above that compression lock. You have a kind of a big thumb rest here. There's no jimping on that up here, but it's a nice place for your thumb to land if you're holding it right here. And folks, as far as the utility of this, again, this was not designed for utility work. It was designed for self-defense. But man, look at this point I'm talking about. This is needle-like point, and they have a really high, probably a two-thirds of the way up, crazy hollow grind on this. Look at that, folks. This thing is a scoring, a slicing machine. So it doesn't have to, I mean, you know, you don't have to go be a kung fu master to own this knife. If you want a good utility knife, this doubles as, I'm telling you, it is a slicer. It is a draw cutting dream, which is what I, you know, like I said, I'm not trained as in knife fighting. I just thought it was unique. This is one that's in my collection. Kind of wild, but I went for it. What can I say? But I will tell you, it's comfortable. You may not like the looks of it. You either do or you don't on the looks. I can't sell you on that. I'm not even going to try because I get it. It's a polarizing aesthetic to this guy. But it's comfortable. If you do like it, or you're somehow on the middle fence, if you're on the fence on this, which I doubt, but it is comfortable and it is a cutter. It is a slicer. So, like I say, you don't have to be Bruce Lee to own this. If you want a good, comfortable, ergonomic knife that does cut, this can be your huckleberry. But you're either going to get past the looks, or you may love this looks. You may think this is the coolest thing since sliced bread. I don't think it's the coolest thing since sliced bread. Obviously, it was unique enough for me to purchase, and then I kind of tricked this out. This is when I was really in my modern phase and customizing knives and chasing that new build, which I'm not anymore. But when I was, this is an example of that time in my life that I was doing all that. But anyway, show you a little of that action. Press this compression lock here, and she starts to fall. Big thumb deployment hole here. You probably could deploy this thing with this. We'll try it. I'm sure I'll fail. See if we can deploy it out with just this compression lock. You can. Back in. Knew I'd fail if I pressed my luck, but you can open and close it through the compression lock here, or do as just it's intended with this big, huge, comfortable spotty hole. Just bam. She is out there. She is deployed, ready to go. But anyway, folks, if I hadn't mentioned, this is an S30V, CPM S30V steel. So I don't have a real super upgraded, exotic steel on this. This was a base knife. When I was doing my customizing, I would usually just get the base model because I know I was going to add scales. I was going to black wash it, put, titanium hardware or whatever. So I would get a, more base model because I already knew that I was going to be adding money to it. But this is, which, S30V, in my opinion, is an awesome steel. I say it was the base model. I mean, these do come in like M4, and I think maybe there's a variant in S90V. But this is just the old CPM S30V here that has been black washed and, of course, heavily customized. But Randy, I hope this is okay to show a modern on Wharncliffe Wednesday. The Spyderco Yojimbo 2. And guys, get over there and check Brother Randy out. Great guy, great channel. Probably if you're watching me, you may have found me through this guy. Who knows? I know some have. But by chance, if you're not subbed to his channel, you're going to want to do that. It is an awesome channel. So, that being said, we're going to get off here. We're at the 10-minute mark. Yeah. Check out the old Spyderco Yojimbo 2. drop me a comment. I know there'll be some because, like I said, this is a conversation piece for sure. But right down here, you guys know what to do. Happy Valentine's Day again to you, all you ladies out there. Take them out to dinner tonight, guys. Show them you love them. And we're going to see you on the next one. God bless. HT signing off.